frameshift drive charging. Surface scanned by 50%. Surface scan complete.
Strike. Relations between the Empire and the Federation have deteriorated following a terror attack by Neo-Marlinists against a federal starport. Kepler Orbital in the Atropos system was bombed by the NMLA to eliminate several of its captured members before they could reveal anything under interrogation by the Federal Security Service. Imperial Ambassador Imogen Luciana made this statement. The NMLA was obviously able to make use of its bomb-making factories within the LTT-1935 system. If the Federation had not resisted our investigation, we would have shut these down and prevented the attack. Our warning about the extremist threat went unheeded, and the Federation is now paying the price. We once again insist that all Marlinists are repatriated to the Empire. Ambassador Jordan Rochester has not responded, but did confirm that federal embassies in several imperial systems have closed after violent anti-Marlinist protests placed diplomatic staff's lives at risk. In Congress, Vice President Brad Mitchell directly blamed Shadow President Felicia Winters for the recent attack. He accused her of laying out the welcome mat for terrorists by offering sanctuary to the Marlinists. Other congressmen argued that she had prioritized aid for imperial rather than federal citizens. There is evidence that Winters is now losing some of her recently gained political capital. However, the Liberal Party's popularity remains high in the wake of President Hudson's alleged association with the destruction of Starship One.
Complete.
Surface scanned by 50%. Surface scan complete. Surface scanned by 50%. Surface scan complete. 50%. Surface scan complete.
superpowers react to latest NMLA strike. Relations between the Empire and the Federation have deteriorated following a terror attack by Neo-Marlinists against a federal starport. Kepler orbital in the Atropos system was bombed by the NMLA to eliminate several of its captured members before they could reveal anything under interrogation by the Federal Security Service. Imperial Ambassador Imogen Luciana made this statement. The NMLA was obviously able to make use of its bomb-making factories within the LTT-1935 system. If the Federation had not resisted our investigation, we would have shut these down and prevented the attack. Our warning about the extremist threat went unheeded, and the Federation is now paying the price. We once again insist that all Marlinists are repatriated to the Empire. Ambassador Jordan Rochester has not responded, but did confirm that federal embassies in several imperial systems have closed after violent anti-Marlinist protests placed diplomatic staff's lives at risk. In Congress, Vice President Brad Mitchell directly blamed Shadow President Felicia Winters for the recent attack. He accused her of laying out the welcome mat for terrorists by offering sanctuary to the Marlinists. Other congressmen argued that she had prioritized aid for imperial rather than federal citizens. There is evidence that Winters is now losing some of her recently gained political capital. However, the Liberal Party's popularity remains high in the wake of President Hudson's alleged association with the destruction of Starship One.